Hello everyone and welcome. In this quick tutorial, I'm going to explain how does a Spring Boot application look when you first create a project from Spring Initializer. I've just created a project from Spring Initializer. My project name is Mail. And as you can see, under the source folder, there is a folder named Maint and Java. And under the Java folder, I have the root package for my application, which is com.avc.mail. And inside that, we have only one class which is containing the main method from where the Spring application starts. So when you start writing your code for the first time, you will be creating your package under this as you want to structure your project. So a typical way will be creating some other packages like controller, services, repository, model, etc. So all our code goes under this package. We have another folder here under source main, which is resources. This is the default class path of your Spring Boot application. And here the most important thing is application.properties. This is basically a properties file where you configure the things like your server port, your database connection, mail configuration, and many more. So this is a very helpful and very important file. I'll come back on this in my following tutorials. But for now, let's say you put all your configuration on this file. By default, this is empty. And under my main, we got Java source. And we have another folder under the source folder, which is test. So all things related to testing, unit testing, integration testing goes to this. This also contains a main method like the application. And here the most important thing is the pom.xml. So this is actually a Maven build file. This file is for Maven. We have two different options for packaging in Spring Boot. One is Maven, one is Gradle. Maven is an XML file, which is this, and this file contains information of the project and configuration details like what library do you want to use, what version of the library you want to use, and your basic information of the application like what is the name of my application, what is the version of Java I'm using. And since I've added only Spring Boot Starter Web, this is here. And if I want to add some other libraries like Lombok or Spring Data JPA, I'll be doing that. So I will also be visiting this file in my following tutorials. So let's now just understand what is the purpose of this file. So this is the basic structure when you first open your Spring Boot application, and you can organize it as you want. Under the main Java and the root package, you can create new packages as you want. And since Spring Boot is actually an IOC framework, so it doesn't matter how you write your code, you just annotate them with appropriate annotation. So that's all guys for this tutorial. The purpose of this tutorial is to make you understand how does the basic Spring Boot application looks. And we got two things to discuss later. One is under resources, application.properties, and another one is pom.xml file. Thanks for watching. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel.